Today's PortSwigger tutorial is entitled JSON Web Token Authentication Bypass via Weak Signing Key. To solve the lab, we must brute force the website's secret key, use it to sign a modified session token that gives us access to the admin panel, and delete the user Carlos. As with the previous labs, we are going to be using Burp's JWT editor extension. First, let's access the lab and log in with the provided credentials, winner Peter. Let's also try accessing the admin panel. We know from the lab's description that the admin panel is located at /admin. Back in Burp, go to proxy HTTP history. The JWT editor extension has highlighted the requests containing a JSON web token. Select the get admin request and send it to repeater. In repeater, go to the JSON web token tab. This time, we cannot bypass the server's security by leaving the JSON web token unsigned. Observe that the signing algorithm is HS256, which is a symmetric keyed hashing algorithm. This means that it uses the same secret key for both generating the signature and validating it. We will have to brute force this secret key. As per the lab's instructions, we are going to use hashcat and this word list of common secrets. First, download the word list. Next, install hashcat if it is not already installed on your device. The installation steps are highlighted in the FAQ. I have hashcat installed on my main machine on Windows. Blasphemy! If we do hashcat -h, we can see some basic examples. We will use the first example, so we need to say -a, so attack mode, 0, which stands for straight, meaning that each line of our word list will be read line by line and tried as a password candidate, -m, so the hash type, followed by the value for JSON web token, followed by our JSON web token, and finally the word list we've just downloaded. To find the hash type for JSON web token, we can just do a find string command or grep for Linux. We get 16500, so this is the hash type we need. Let's put all of this together. So hashcat -a 0 -m 16500, our JSON web token. Copy it from Burp repeater, followed by the path for the downloaded word list. Hashcat finds the secret key, which appears to be secret 1. When using HS256 as the algorithm for signing JSON web tokens, you typically need to base64 encode the secret key before using it for signing. To do this, go to Burp, decode, add the found key, secret 1, in the top window and select encode as base64. Copy the resulting string. Now that we have the secret key, we need to create a new symmetric key with which to sign our JSON web token. This is because, as discussed earlier, HS256 is a symmetric keyed hashing algorithm. For this, go to JWT editor and click on the new symmetric key button. Click generate. Replace the K value with our encoded secret key and click OK. Back in repeater, in the JSON Web Token tab, click the Sign button at the bottom of the page. Select your newly generated signing key. While watching the JWT signature closely, click OK. Observe that it did not change, which confirms that our signing key is the same as the one used by the application. Finally, change the sub property from winner to administrator. Sign the token again and send the request. We get access to the admin panel. Now, all that's left to do is to go to the delete username Carlos page. Copy the path, go back to the raw tab and paste it in the request line. Send the request. We get a 302 found response. If we go back to the admin page, we can see the message "user deleted successfully." Also observe that the delete username Carlos path is no more. Back in the browser, we also see that the lab has been solved. This is it for today's tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye!